Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be painting a pretty little autumn scene. I'm going to go through our colors. So we have titanium white, black, burnt umber, raw sienna, yellow medium, permanent red, ultramarine blue, grass green, and a dioxazine purple or a violet or something like that, some kind of purple shade, either light or dark. And you'll see when we get to that part, you can kind of individualize that if you want. Okay, and then the brushes we're gonna use, I have a sort of medium angle brush for the background, and two smaller size scruffy flat brushes. And then we'll need a liner brush, and that's all you'll need for this tutorial. Okay, let's get started. We're gonna be putting in a sky. So we need some ultramarine blue. You can wet your brush a little bit. And white. So it's gonna be like a lighter shade of blue. Put that in there. You can make this as dark or as light as you want. Mine is gonna be kind of light. And we're just gonna put that in up at the top. And we're gonna go pretty far down. Most of this sky will get covered up. But we do want it to be there so you can see it peeking through like some leaves and things in the background there. And I'm just blending as I go. Make some more of that color. If your brush gets a little dry, you can dip it in water a little bit. And then go right back to it. And we're just going side to side. Nothing fancy. We just want to cover up all the white. Let's make some more of that color. Just follow along with me. And we've gone a little bit further down than half of the canvas. This doesn't have to be an exact science, but I'm going a little bit further down than half of the canvas with this color. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. And then kind of dab it off on the on your paper towel or whatever you have. We're gonna go into our burnt umber. And we're just gonna put kind of like a horizon. Line there. I love this color. It's like a, it has almost like a orangish, reddish tint to it. We're gonna go all the way down with this color, all the way down to the bottom. There's no mixture, it's just burnt umber. And it looks a little light now, but it'll darken up. And we'll go over this again. Don't worry if you have some darker streaks in there. My canvas is moving all over the place. Done with this bottom here. Just get your sides a little bit. I don't do my complete size, but I do right over the edge. And then later I paint my sides black. I like to have it painted black. But if you want to take your color all the way down the sides, you can do that too. Mixed in with mine. That was not on purpose, but I'll work with it. And with that burnt sienna that's left over on your palette, I'm gonna add in some the burnt umber. I'm gonna add in some raw sienna. And I'll put that in there too. I don't know if I keep getting black mixed in. This is really dark. I'm just gonna go up the sides a little bit. Get some of that color in there. Go up the sides a little bit over here as well. And this doesn't have to be any particular way. We're just getting the color in there. This is going to be off in the background. Now I don't have much on my brush. I'm just scrubbing in whatever's left on my brush. I'm not reloading, I'm just scrubbing in what's ever left and blending it in. I'm gonna just put our horizon line back in with some more burnt umber. We
kind of lost it. I'll put some. And I'm gonna put some more on the sides. Make it darker. So. Okay. Can rinse your brush out. Get all that brown out of there. Now I want you to get either a small round or a kind of like liner brush. We're gonna sketch in our little. We're gonna have a little VW bug in here, and we're just gonna do a simple sketch of it. It'll be pretty simple. Just follow along with me, and I'm using black to sketch this in, and we want it kind of in the middle. And this is going to be a little convertible. So we're going to start off by doing just a little line. Don't worry, we can fix it as we go. Just follow along with what I'm doing. This is going to be the convertible part of our little VW bug here. And you don't have to be like a super great artist. Just follow along with me. If you need to pause and complete a step, you can go ahead and do that. So that'll be the little convertible part. And this will be the front, the windshield. Kind of like that's the front windshield. I'm just gonna rectangle shape. Okay, got that. I hope this is easy for you to follow along with. Okay. Okay, so we got that part. Now this is going to be the back of the car. Just follow along with me. I'm going to take this part and we're going to I don't know what all these parts are called. I'm not like a big car person. Just hang in there with me and follow along. I'm trying to make it as symmetrical as I can. Some rare lights in. They're kind of like a circle shape. We'll do one on that side, one on this side. We don't want to make this too technical. This is going to be like, I think this is like the trunk of the car. It goes around like this. Just bear with me. There's these little vent things. These might get covered up when we paint the car. These might get covered up. I don't know if we'll leave these in here. And then we have the license plate. Okay. And that is our little sketch. Wow. I'll take this a little bit more. There any like VW enthusiasts out there, don't drag me for this. We don't need it to be just want the general idea. Okay. So that's our little car sketch, and we'll come back to that later. We'll get some more stuff in around it. And I'm gonna switch to a flat brush. This is the size of the flat brush, if you can see it. And we're gonna get some red. Oh, spilled some water. We need some red and a little bit of yellow. I want like an orangey color, but it'll be mostly red. And we're just gonna tap this color in. These are gonna be leaves. Just gonna tap this in. On both sides of the car. And down below. This is just going to be our little leaves here. If some are more red than others, that's fine. I'm mixing some more of that color and I'm just tapping it in. We'll do that on both sides. And I'm just randomly tapping and getting this color in. It's just, I love the colors in autumn. Living in Las Vegas, I don't get to actually see it, but I love seeing it in other places, seeing pictures of these fall colors and all these like burnt oranges and burgundies and, you know, all these different colors. I wish I got to see it here, but I probably wouldn't appreciate it as much if I saw it all the time. But I love painting it. Okay. There's some out here. I want to mix some more of that orangish color, and I want to put it down below as if it's like fallen leaves and things like that. So I'm going to go beneath our horizon line and just spread some of this color out. get some of that color down in here. On this side too. Don't forget this side. And we're going below the horizon line. We don't want to lose our horizon line. Spreading it out all along here. A little more red in that mixture. I just want to get some more colors out here. Still yellow and red, but just a little less yellow this time. Okay, and now we want to do another mixture of yellow and red, but a lot more yellow. We wanted a lot more orange this time, so we're adding in mostly yellow to brighten it up quite a bit. So yeah, like a true orange this time. We're gonna tap that in too. I don't like that. So I'm gonna add more yellow. Maybe a little bit of white. To really brighten that up, that orange. Yeah, that's a lot better. We're just gonna tap that in too. Do both sides, tap that in. And we're going to put a little bit of that down here too. Tap it in. We don't want to cover up everything that we just did, but we want to put it in, get it in there. Get some color down here. Too.
Okay, now we're gonna get mostly just yellow. If a little bit of that other mixture gets in, that's okay. But it'll be mostly yellow. And we're just gonna, again, tap that in there. We don't want too much of this. We just want pops of yellow. Again, we want just a little bit down here, that yellow down there. Not too much. Just little highlights of it. And white, and that'll be our final highlight for these trees. And we're just gonna lightly tap. There'll be even less of these highlights. I want them to pop out a lot. So that was just yellow and white. We'll do some over here. Just lightly tapping these in, these little highlights in. On both sides. And down here again. Some of that down here. Okay, you can rinse your brush out. And wipe it off on your towel. We're gonna go back to our liner brush. And we just wanna put some little tree trunks in here. They're not gonna be anything complicated. We're just going to put a few in random spots with our burnt umber. And you're just going to do a couple little tree trunks and branches.
And this is light pressure with your small liner brush. The lighter the pressure, the thinner the lines will be. The more pressure you put, the thicker the lines will be. And we're just doing little hints of some trees down here, tree trunks. Just little hints of it. Some of these I'm not even making solid lines, as if they're hidden behind leaves. Okay. And then also with the burnt umber, I just want to do a little shadowing where this road is, the edge of the road. I just want to do a couple little shadows in there. This is with just straight burnt umber, and I'm just doing a little, kind of like edge of the road. And this is not a straight line or anything. I'm just creating where edge of this road might be. It's not super defined, basically, is what I'm saying. There's no wrong way to do it. I just want to get it in there. And also, before we get started on the car, I want to put some of this burnt under underneath, as if that's the shadow for the car. If you like the way yours looks, you don't have to do this part. I think it would look fine either way. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out.
believe it or not, we're almost done with this little painting. So, oh, one more thing. I did, because there's a lot of reds and yellows, I did want to add in a little bit of green. Now, if you don't want the green in there, you don't have to have it. But I did want to put in a little green in there. And I think I'm going to get my grass green, mix it with a little bit of white. Mix like a really pretty green. I just want to get a couple little green areas in there. Not too much, just a few little, as if, just a couple. I'll do a couple little dabs of green in here. If you don't want to do this step, you don't have to do it either. If you like yours with just the reds and the oranges, I just thought the greens would be a nice little contrast. As if to say, like, yeah, it's fall, but not all the way, not just yet. And all of this underneath, it should be dry enough for you to do this without mixing the colors. Maybe a couple little hints of green in there. I'm gonna add some white to it and make some little highlights. So wherever you put green, add a little white to it and do some little highlights of it. Not too many, just a couple. And if you cover up some of your other leaves, that's fine too. Okay, I think that looks good. Rinse your brush out. And now, our last little step here will be to get our little card done. I think I'm gonna add another brush, and it's just gonna be a smaller flat. Or you can use a slightly bigger round than your, I'm gonna use a slightly bigger round than my liner brush. And you can do your car any color you want. I'm choosing to do like a purple car. It's my favorite color, and if I had one of these kind of cars, it would be purple. So that's why I'm doing it. Also, it'll contrast pretty good with the yellow tones that we have in here, since it's the complement of purple is a complement of yellow. So I'm just gonna be kind of precious, and I want to leave my black lines in there. And I'm starting back here because it's the biggest area, and it'll be the easier part to paint in. Look at that purple, isn't that pretty?
so, and this is all going to be purple. Going around our little lights. We'll go around this one too. I'm trying not to erase my sketch lines because I actually want the black lines to be in there. And we'll do some highlighting as well. Looks kind of strange before you fill it in. You have all the background colors in there. Going around our little license plate here. And remember I said we might cover up these, I don't know what they're called. They're like little vent things. And I'm just gonna, I added a little bit of water to my paint so I can go over without completely erasing them or covering them up. So I can still see them a little bit. Then we have our little trunk opener thing. Okay, and all we're doing is just filling in this that little sketch that we did earlier. That's all we're doing. So just follow along. I see like there's like some, I know there's like exhausts and, you know, and things like that. I think that's what they're called, the little exhaust pipes or something in the back. We don't have to do all of that. When I was younger, this was my, VWs were my favorite cars, and I told myself, when I get older, I'm gonna get one. That never happened, but that's okay. I can paint them. Okay, rinse your brush out. We're gonna let all that purple dry, and we're gonna put in the little convertible. Follow along with me. We're getting our black. Okay, so we're gonna add white. We're gonna make a gray color. So black and white. I wanna add a little bit more white. Make it a lighter gray. I'm gonna add some more white to make that gray even lighter. I'm gonna put in a couple highlights. A little bit more white. Just adding some contrast. Okay. We'll add some black when you need a darker color. So we'll add some black to that mixture and make it kind of almost completely black for the tires and fill those in. And we'll get some white and with the black left on, we'll just add white to make a grayish color and kind of outline our tires with that gray color. And then we'll add some white. With that gray color, we're going to put that in over here. I don't know what this is called, bumper, I guess. And that's going to be gray. Supposed to be like a metal type of deal. And with our black, we kind of lost, I kind of lost my line here. There's supposed to be a black line right down the middle. So I'm just putting that back in. And if you lost any of your lines, you can put them back in right now. So I'm just putting in those sketch lines that I made earlier. Just putting those back in. This was supposed to go all the way down. So I'm just fixing my sketch a little bit. Okay. So we were a little off on the sketch earlier, but that's okay. I'm gonna leave it. Okay, rinse your brush out, and we're gonna put our little lights in. And for that, we're gonna use red. There's a little middle part that's red. It's just a little rectangle of red. Like a light orange color. So red and lots of yellow to make an orange. If you want to put a little white in there, you can too. To make it brighter, to make it pop out a little bit more. And rinse my brush out. If you have any more gray that you made earlier, you can use that for this bottom part. A little bit more white. Be like a light gray. Okay. And this is our little license plate. can rinse your brush out. Take that back. We'll put a little gray in the mirror here. Put the little highlights in here. Okay, you can rinse your brush out. And then we're gonna put some highlights on our car. So if you use purple like me, you're gonna add lots of white to that. We want some highlights for our little car here. I'm just gonna, I want it a little bit lighter so it can be almost white. I'm just putting a couple little random highlights in here. So you can do as much of this or as little of this as you want. I might want to add in some more darker. I don't want to take too much of that purple away. Okay, you can rinse your brush out, get all that purple out of there. Go to our white, just a tad bit of black and make a grayish color. We're gonna just highlight this fender. Just a little bit. Can wipe your brush off, and now just with white, we'll do a couple little highlights on it. Also, do it on the license plate. Okay, a couple in the mirror. Just some straight white in the mirror, just a couple little white highlights. And we're almost done. And this is just white that I'm using now. I'm going back to the yellow, mixing a little bit of white. We want to make these the lights pop a little bit more. A little bit of red. A little bit of yellow. And a little bit of white. A little bit more white. A little bit of white on here. And that is our little fall painting. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, or you can email me. All of our materials will be in the description box. And thank you for painting with me. See you next time. Bye.